Hey, John.
What's wrong with you?
I hate Mondays.
Today's Wednesday.
Oh.
Besides, you don't have a job. Welcome to 5 Points of Articulation, where I review action figures and then articulate 5 points to help you decide if you want to add that figure to your collection. The 5 points I discuss are packaging, presentation, posability, playability, and price. I'm Jason, and if you enjoy my content, please like, share, subscribe, do all the YouTube rigmarole. Hey all you cool cats and kittens, today we're going to look at the new Marvel Legends Hasbro Pulse exclusive Tigra. Starting off the packaging, it comes on one of those Toy Biz style retro cards. Nice big picture of Tigra here. Down here we have a promise of a cat's head amulet, which, unless you're enough of a fan to know that it's talking about that thing holding her bikini top together, might be kind of confusing. Same artwork on the back, fast feline reflexes and a prehensile tail make Tigra a dazzling force to be reckoned with. In general, I don't like when Hasbro uses this style of packaging for characters who didn't appear in this original line. It just kind of feels like they're trying to manufacture nostalgia. There's also the fact that you have to kind of destroy the box just to open it. If you do want to be able to reuse the package, the technique that I use is taking a sharp knife and poking it right there at the seam. Then, carefully follow along the edge. Leave the top untouched, and then not only can you pull it out, you can also put it back. Since the figure's marketed for collectors, I'm pretty sure the collectors know what they're getting. And personal preferences aside, on its own merit, it's fine. So for packaging, I'm giving Tigra 1 whole point. Moving on to presentation, and Tigra stands at 6¼ inches. In addition to a sculpted on costume, she also has patches of fur all over, as well as a tail. Her face has some obviously very feline features, and if you zoom in, you can see that they did a great job of painting the Eye of the Tiger! Come on, you knew it was coming when you clicked on this video. You know how I do. But in all seriousness, it's a very lovely face sculpt, though I will say I think that the head seems a little bit small for the body, but it's not like action figures ever exaggerate proportions. I really like the auburn that they used for her hair, and there's a very nice, very subtle wash in it that really brings it out. And one little touch I like is that even though her ear is covered on this side, it is uncovered on this one, so that way you can see that her ears are pointed. Moving on down, and like I said, her costume is sculpted on. The paint job's a little bit fuzzy, and it definitely gets all woohoozy under the armpit, but all of her stripes are very nicely painted. As I said, she's got little patches of fur all throughout. Her elbows and knees don't exactly match the rest of her, but that is unfortunately kind of common. Flipping her around, and we can see that she has a tail. I was very surprised to discover that it actually just pops out, and the less said about Tigra's butthole, the better. Between the furry arms and legs, as well as the clawed hands and feet, it would absolutely not surprise me if they reused her for Feral and Wolfsbane. Speaking of her feet, there are a couple of really weird notches in them. Like, is this some kind of cost-cutting measure to save plastic? I'd also like to point out that all of the joints are pinless. Normally, I'd mention that during posability, but I just wanted to mention it here because it really improves the overall aesthetic. Aside from the paint slop, my only other minor criticism is the shade of orange that they cast her in. She kind of looks like a Cheeto. Dangerously cheesy. I've been waiting years for Hasbro to give us a high-quality Tigra, and it really looks like she leapt off the comic book page. For a presentation, I'm giving Tigra 1 whole point. Moving on to posability, and this is where things get really interesting. Starting from the top, her head is on a dumbbell joint. She can't really look up because of the hair, but she can look down, little bit of tilt, and all the way around. She has swivel hinge shoulders that move up way above 90 degrees, and almost unheard of for a lady legend, she has bicep swivel and double jointed elbows. And they've got a really great range. Swivel hinge for her wrists. No waist, of course, but she has a diaphragm joint. Using that joint, she can arch back that much and hunch over that much. And of course, great side to side. Moving on down, she has ball jointed hips, decent enough spread, thigh cut, pinless double jointed knees, ankles that click back, click forward, and pivot, and of course, a poseable tail. And I'm actually surprised to say you really can hang her from it. Is this the single greatest integration of sculpting and articulation in a female Marvel legend? I don't know, maybe, but I like it. For posability, I'm giving Tigra 1 whole point. Moving on to playability, and Tigra comes with these fists, which I'll probably never use, and this alternate savage head that I'll probably never take off. Zooming on in, we can see she has some sharp teeth, and because the hair is sculpted away from the body, this head actually can look up a bit, as well as look down. Luckily for Tigra, playability is more than just accessories, it's also about how well your figure plays with others. So here she is with some classic Avengers. We have the 80 years Iron Man, Thor, and Hulk. Hiya, buddy! there? Oh, bother.
Not much of a Winnie the Pooh parody for not much of a YouTube channel.
For a wee bitty West Coast Avengers comparison, here she is with the Silver Centurion Iron Man, War Machine, and Scarlet Witch. Can you tell I need more West Coast Avengers? For a fellow feline comparison, here she is with the DC Designer Series Greg Capullo Catwoman, the DC Essentials Cheetah, and the Marvel Legends Black Cat. Between the center parted hair, animal print fur, claws, articulated tails, and decorative teeth, these two definitely have a lot in common.
Nothing good comes from lies, Barbara. You cannot win because you're a cheetah, and cheetahs never win.
I think you're confusing me for someone else.
You know, I can't put my finger on it, but there's just something about you I like.
Who is she?
Nah, girl, it ain't like that. She don't mean nothing to me.
For a more Tigra-specific comparison, here she is with a figure made by Toy Biz for the Avengers United They Stand animated series. To be honest, this is kinda closer to the shade of orange I wish the new one was, and oddly enough, this one also has a chunk taken out of her foot. For a relative scale comparison, here she is with Pizza Spidey and the Spectacular Spider-Man. In general, she seems kinda tiny, but she does stand head and shoulders over Stealth Iron Man. She doesn't come with a lot of accessories, but to be honest, she doesn't really need to. For her playability, I'm giving Tigra one whole point. Before we continue to our final category, I just want to take a moment to thank you for watching this video so far. If you like this video, do me a favor and give it a like. I put a lot of love into these videos, and your likes help more people to see them. This leaves us with nothing left to discuss but the price. I picked up Tigra at GameStop for $22.99. I wouldn't go so far as to say I'm never going to financially recover from this, but it's definitely a bit steep. Unfortunately, this is the new standard. Luckily, as fictional felines go, Tigra's great. For price, I'm giving Tigra one whole point for a grand total of 5 out of 5. For more Marvel Legends, check out this review of the new Infinity Saga Mark III Iron Man. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be back again real soon, but until then, play nice and have fun.